So the CEO emailed me. I haven't opened it fully. I look cute. Date night.
It's the brown stuff.
What brown stuff?
Right there. If you want to actually eat.
Oh, what a glorious morning it is, Tom. Okay guys, so I just finished my meeting with my manager and she casually dropped in that my second meeting or my third meeting of the day, the whole CEO is gonna be tuning in because it's for one of the major clients. I'm like, so yeah, just mentioning this now. So I thought, you know, let me just put a small concealer. Let me try to look my best, give CEO something good. So I'm not really nervous, like I'm good at what I do, so let's do it. Got my second meeting in 8 minutes and then the third one, that's the one with the CEO. So yeah, coffee's been good, day's been good so far. I will catch you guys probably after the meeting with the CEO, let you guys know how that went. I don't think he's ever seen me in action doing what I do, so it's always good to have that visibility in your company where the top guys, because they'll hear about how good you are if you're good, like your manager should be feeding that back. But it's a whole different ball game when they see you do what you do, so he gonna really see today. All right, I'll catch you guys later. So guys, I just finished my demo that my CEO sat in on, and to be honest, smashed it. And I think stuff like this, having good visibility within your company, is so important when it comes to your annual reviews and you're asking for, I don't know, whatever your packages you're asking for, more holiday, more money, more benefits. It's good when the people above, the people that are going to be accepting or approving, know your value and they know what you bring to the company. Hashtag pancakes. So very happy with that. I'm gonna have a, I think my manager's having a debrief with the CEO, and I'll have a debrief with my manager after and just get her feedback on what she thought. But I have so much work to do. I'll catch you guys in a bit. Okay guys, so the CEO emailed me. I haven't opened it fully. This is so weird, but I can already see like the start of it, so I'm gonna open it and just read you guys what he says. He goes, "Hi Mimi, I just witnessed an incredible demo of the solution I'm in charge of to a client that creates all of their own software and is known for being hard to please. Your subject knowledge is incredible. You operated the software whilst talking through it. You're a natural. I think you can do very well with this product. Well done." And he CC'd my manager and her manager in it as well. So obviously I'm very happy. Yeah, so you have to now reply something like super humble. But yeah, I'm very happy. So I just love the incredible part. Oh, so happy. I just want to call my sister and tell her the visibility that this shit gets you. Like, don't bow away from the opportunity when it arises. Like, I've been doing these demos, I do like 4 or 5 a day sometimes, and in the almost 6 months I've been here, this is the first one, and I might not get another one that the CEO sits in on again. So they sprung it on me this morning, I didn't know, but I'm very happy. But I did my ish. All right, stop smiling, let me crack on with the work. I'll catch you guys in a bit. So I was gonna cook dinner tonight, but I ended up getting a takeaway, which is almost here. I think we got Thai. Oh my God, my throat really hurts. Let's get in the door. And I look cute. Late night, so no cooking. What's for dinner, babe? The good stuff. Dishes. I think they're still in the dishwasher. Actually, yeah. Let me see that.
Only one.
Yeah, you know what to eat. Why not?
Gracias,
guapo.
Why
are you grumpy?
I'm hungry. I need
Are you hungry? You a bit hungry?
What spring rolls are these?
Vegetables. No, actually, no, it's beef spring rolls. Beef spring rolls. What'd you get?
So you got spring rolls that I can't eat, yeah?
Is that what I did?
Basically.
Is that what I did?
I think so.
Oh, I did it on purpose.
Yeah, you did.
How do you know? Do you have proof? Do you have evidence to back this theory up?
I don't believe that you're that selfish.
Your pad thai looks banging. Can't wait to eat that. You're breaking apart my spring roll. Don't you see the beef in it? It's the brown stuff.
What brown stuff?
Right there. You want to actually eat beef spring roll?
That's not spinach.
Okay, fine. I didn't get beef spring rolls. I got vegetable ones. Maybe we could be Instagram famous. I can't believe you're eating my spring rolls. Oh, that's disgusting. I can't eat whatever that is. I don't want it. What is that? Is it sweet chili?
Because you don't want it. You mean I don't want it.
Is it sweet chili?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I can eat that. The spring rolls I get from the Chinese place are so much better than these.
You haven't tried that.
Hmm? Well, I mean, you literally get double the portion.
Sometimes it's about quality.
And they taste so much better than these.
They say.
Can you eat fast, please, so you can stop being cranky?
Yeah.
I'd show you his pad thai, but he's actually eating everything. Hey guys, so date night last night went well. What do? We ended up watching a movie. It wasn't a very good one. It was Now You See Me 2, but I was feeling super ill yesterday. Like, I was coughing, like my throat was so sore. I've had a sore throat though for like a few weeks now. I've been like popping strepsils non-stop, but I was really coughing. I felt super ill yesterday. So it wasn't the best night, and I had a chill day at work, which I always appreciate when it's not super busy. I've made a big decision today that I'm excited about. Bring the wig forward. So yeah, I'm just sitting at home because I got my delivery for my push-up tape for some hauls I want to film this weekend. I'm not sure if I will because I'm definitely not at goal weight, but I love this product. Let me try to do this with one hand. Get me my package. So I just got my push-up tape. I bought it. I bought it before, after I was influenced by Sincere Liuosa, and it's just skin taped tape for us chat lady girls. Oh, I did have a feeling I got the darker one this time. I got the darkest option, which is a little bit too dark. Is that a little too dark? I don't know. It's manageable though. I think last time I got the lighter option, which is more in tune with like my chest, but this is good. But yeah, I really like this. It's a bit pricey, I feel like, but for what you get, it's like £25-26, but for what you get, the lift you get, the versatility you get with different outfits, banging. So yeah, it's Friday night. I was meant to go to the store because I'm having Kiki over. I'm having my brother over. I'm having my sister over for lunch tomorrow. I'm making like suya and jollof rice. I was meant to go to the store and pick up the bits and start seasoning the chicken from tonight, but that's not happening. So it's okay. We'll do that tomorrow. They can eat freshly seasoned chicken. But yeah, I'm just chilled. I'm trying to decide, do I want to bring the TV in here? Maybe just put it on the stand and just watch TV in bed, or do I want to get my projector and just put it on the wall? I don't know. I think I'll get the TV because we're watching the release of Coming to America 2. I'm coming to America. And the quality on the projector just isn't as good as obviously on a HD TV, so I think I'm gonna grab the TV and just have a lovely chilled evening alone, watch that movie, or do I wanna watch it in the living room? I don't know, options, but I just thought I'd come and talk and chat to you guys and catch you up on date night. Taking it each day at a time, we get along quite well. I'm gonna roll today because this double chin is really starting to, piss me off. I put on some false nails today because I was just like, jazz it up a bit. I'm gonna roll my jade roller tonight. But anyway, guys, it's the weekend. We are vlogging. We are feeling good. I've got a big announcement coming soon. But yeah, catch you in a bit. Good morning, guys. So I am just getting out of bed. I think it's just gone 9. I've been watching a bit of Mariam Musa, her flat tour on YouTube. Do you know, I haven't watched YouTube in months, like literally months. Honestly, I've just felt a whole detachment towards that platform, resentment, people I used to watch all the time. I don't even want to watch because I feel like YouTube and I, we're not in a good place. YouTube be hating on me, like, why is my channel stagnant and not growing and whatnot? But I'm feeling so much better. I made a big, big life decision yesterday. It'll be a few weeks before I, you know, act on it, so you guys will find out in due course. But oh, what a glorious morning it is to wake up in such beautiful, bright environment. But today I've got family and a friend coming over for lunch and some filming and some Instagram. So for people that are like, oh, we're still in lockdown, I know you guys may not like it, but I am an influencer, hate that word. This is what I do for work. People want to watch content that have more than just myself in it. So I'm going to give you guys what you want. And the government cannot tell me nothing because they collect my tax money from my influencing. So yeah, I just got up. I'm gonna make myself a coffee as I usually do most mornings. My room is relatively tidy. I probably need to make my bed. What am I doing today? Okay, so I'm gonna exercise. I'm gonna do my Zumba. I am going to, I think I'm then going to go to the store and get some chicken and season it, because for lunch I'm making jollof rice. Oh, look at my nails, it looks so cute. I'm making jollof rice and I'm making chicken suya. Tell you, girl can cook, your girl can cook. So I gotta go get some ingredients and then I'm going to season it. I'm gonna drive to B&Q because I need to get 2 stalls, because one thing about entertaining my flat is that our breakfast bar or our table, oh god, guys, look at this. This is probably the messiest you will ever see this living room, and I know that it's because my housemate's currently away. She's like, yeah, she's gone away. So I am sort of letting myself spread out a bit. Shouldn't spread out too much, girl. So yeah, anyway, the breakfast bar only has 2 tables, 2 chairs, 2 seats. So I'm gonna pop down to B&Q. There was some I saw there I didn't absolutely love, but all the other ones I've seen on Amazon, I haven't loved either. So I'm just gonna get the 2 that I saw from B&Q so that when I have lunch and have everybody over, we can just all sit down at the table, because otherwise I'm usually sat on a much lower chair down here. or I have to sit on the sofa, so that's what I'm gonna do as well. So yeah, I think we'll make coffee now, tidy up a little bit in here. I was working on that table yesterday. And just get myself together for my day. I also want to film that misguided haul. I've had that package now for almost 2 weeks, if not 2 weeks. Have you guys seen haul? I have not seen haul though. So I want to film that. And to obviously shower as well. Do my hair. I've got lots to do, guys, but yeah, I'm gonna be vlogging and vlogging again, yay. So yeah, all right, I'll catch you guys in a bit. Time for morning Zumba, let's do this. So guys, I'm just been seasoning the chicken. I've washed it, I've cut off all the extra fat and skin. Well, I got some thighs and I got some wings. So I've salted it, I've put diced onions in, I'm about to add in scotch bonnets, I think maybe 1 each. And then I've got some Maggi cubes and gnaw cubes that I've
put in the microwave to dissolve that I'm going to sprinkle over it. And the last thing I add in is quite a bit of barbecue sauce and then quite a bit of hot sauce, and then I massage it in and leave it, usually for 24 hours at least. But this is still gonna bang, especially because I'm grilling it on the fire, so I feel like it absorbs more flavor there. Oh, and I also add in a dash of olive oil as well. So yeah, I'm gonna quickly wrap up here, head to B&Q, and then come back. It's already 11:30. My first guest is arriving at 1. My sister will probably be here for 2, so got to get a move on. And I was thinking as well, apart from the side tables, I don't actually have any place settings or mats, so it'd be nice to get maybe some woven basket ones as well for the table. I'm at B&Q in Greenwich. Fun to get the stuff I need. Literally one of my favorite things to do is like home shop, so I have to be super careful in places like this that I don't buy stuff I don't need. Like half of my home is from B&Q. I just love B&Q. Okay, let's see, maybe here. So guys, I'm back from the store and I'm pretty happy. Like, I spent a bit of money, but I don't think I went massively over what I would have expected to spend for what I bought. I got quite a bit. I'm gonna start putting everything together because I'm actually running a little bit late. Let me check my phone actually, because Kiki should have been here by now. Kiki! Oh no, have I left my phone in the car? Guys, I'm starving. It's gone 1 o'clock and I realize I haven't eaten anything all day, just my morning coffee. Down in some plantain chips. So something new that I kind of decided I was going to start doing is I'm going to start buying myself fresh flowers, maybe once every 2 weeks. Just like a little treat to myself, a little something to brighten up my week. So I went and got a vase. This wasn't the one I wanted to get, but I feel like in the meantime it will do until I find the right vase for me. But I wanted a clear one. I'm just going to fill it with water. And this is the bouquet I got. I just thought that'd be very pleasant for hosting a little luncheon. So I don't have a green thumb by any stretch of the imagination, but I know you're meant to cut the shoots in an upwards sort of diagonal position, just to make sure the absorption of the water and food is maximized. So I'm gonna pop this in and then start to, you know, I'm gonna remove the leaves. I really don't like the leaves. Okay. Should they be here or should we put them more in the center of the table as like a centerpiece? The only thing is when we're here eating, I just don't want it to be like we can't see each other. So I think maybe we'll just keep it there for now. And then when the food is here, we can have the food in the center. And then maybe when we're not having dinner, I can move it into the center. I don't know, but I'm gonna play around with it and see what I like. But I really like the placemats. It's cute. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do that.